Egypt and Exodus, an introduction, transition from providence to oppression. The journey of Jacob's family to Egypt, initially under God's providential care, represents a significant shift in the biblical narrative of Exodus. This movement marks the beginning of a dramatic change in the fortunes of the Israelites, from being guests in a land of refuge to becoming victims of oppression. The famine in Canaan, a catalyst for change. The severe famine in Canaan, which threatened the survival of Jacob's family, led to their initial migration to Egypt. This move, while driven by the immediate need for sustenance, was part of a larger divine plan. The providential hand of God can be seen in the way Joseph, once sold into slavery by his brothers, rises to become a key figure in Egypt, thereby providing a haven for his family. The rise and fall of Joseph's legacy. During Joseph's tenure as vizier, he effectively manages the resources of Egypt, saving not only the Egyptians, but also his own family from the devastating effects of the famine. However, with the passage of time and the advent of the new Pharaoh, Joseph's contributions and his family's status in Egypt are forgotten. This change in royal attitude marks the beginning of a drastic transformation in the Israelites' circumstances. The new Pharaoh's fear and the ensuing oppression. The new Pharaoh, feeling threatened by the growing number of Israelites and oblivious to their historical contribution to the nation's prosperity, initiates a series of oppressive measures. His actions are motivated by fear of the Israelites' potential alliance with enemies or their overpowering of the Egyptians themselves. This period is characterized by harsh labor and brutal treatment. As the Israelites are reduced to slaves, building cities and monuments for the Pharaoh. The shift from guests to slaves. The Israelites transition from honored guests during Joseph's time to oppressed slaves under the new Pharaoh reflects the precariousness of their situation in a foreign land. Their descent into slavery set the stage for the story of Exodus, highlighting themes of deliverance and divine intervention in the face of human injustice and suffering. Conclusion. Setting the stage for Exodus. The initial chapters of Exodus, therefore, set the stage for one of the most significant narratives in the Bible. They portray the transition from a period of divine providence and protection to one of oppression and suffering, leading to the need for a divinely orchestrated deliverance. This historical and spiritual journey of the Israelites in Egypt lays the groundwork for understanding the deeper themes of freedom, faith, and God's redemptive power and are central to the Exodus story. God calls Moses, Exodus 1-4. Egyptian oppression of Israel, the ignorance of Joseph's legacy. The shift in the Egyptian monarchy leads to a significant change in the treatment of the Israelites. The new Pharaoh, either unaware or indifferent to Joseph's instrumental role in saving Egypt during the famine, views the growing Israelite population as a threat rather than an asset. This lack of recognition of Joseph's contributions marks the beginning of a period of intense suffering for the Israelites. The fear of the Egyptian monarchy. Pharaoh's fear of the Israelites' increasing numbers is rooted in concerns over national security and political control. The Egyptians worry that the Israelites might align with their enemies or become powerful enough to challenge the existing order. This fear leads to preemptive and oppressive measures to subjugate and control the Israelite population. Harsh labor and building project. One of the primary methods of oppression is to subject the Israelites to rigorous and brutal labor. They are forced into large-scale building projects, constructing cities and monuments that serve both as symbols of Egyptian power and as a means to exhaust and control the Israelite workforce. The labor is not just physically demanding, but is also designed to break their spirit and diminish their capacity to resist or rebel. The groaning under slavery. The impact of this harsh labor on the Israelites is profound. They find themselves groaning under the weight of their bondage, suffering not just physically, but also emotionally and spiritually. The burden of slavery is a constant reminder of the oppressed and marginalized status in a land where they were once welcomed as guests. The setting for divine intervention. This period of oppression set the stage for the narrative of divine intervention and liberation that follows. The Israelites groaning under slavery reaches a point where it cries out for relief, paving the way for God's redemptive action. Their suffering in Egypt becomes a key aspect of their collective memory, shaping their identity as a people who have experienced deliverance from oppression. Conclusion: the significance of the oppression. The Egyptian oppression of the Israelites is a critical element in the Exodus story. It represents the depths of despair from which God's liberating action will raise them. This phase of their slavery is essential in understanding the magnitude of the deliverance that is to come, highlighting the themes of suffering, hope, and the need for the divine salvation. The midwives' defiance and Pharaoh's decrees. Pharaoh's drastic population control measures. Concerned about the burgeoning population of the Israelites, Pharaoh implements a severe and morally reprehensible policy aimed at population control. He orders the midwives who attend to the Jewish women to kill all newborn Hebrew boys. This decree represents an escalation in the Egyptian oppression, moving from forced labor to outright genocide. The courageous defiance of the midwives. The midwives, identified in the biblical narrative as Sipra and Pua, are faced with a profound moral dilemma: obey the king's command or preserve innocent lives. In an act of remarkable bravery and faith, they choose to defy the Pharaoh's order. Their actions are motivated by their fear of God, which in this context refers to their reverence and respect for divine laws and morality over the edicts of a human ruler. The midwives' subtle resistance. The midwives' resistance is not overt, but rather subtle and clever. They excuse their inability to carry out the king's command by claiming that Hebrew women give birth quickly, before the midwives arrived. This act of civil disobedience highlights their moral integrity and their commitment to preserving life despite the risk involved in defying Pharaoh's authority. Pharaoh's escalation and oppression. Frustrated by the failure of his initial decree, Pharaoh then resorts to a more direct and brutal method to reducing the Hebrew population. He commands that every newborn Hebrew boy be thrown into the Nile River, effectively turning his subjects into enforcers of his cruel policy. This command represents one of the darkest moments in the narrative, illustrating the extent of Pharaoh's inhumanity. the suffering of the Israelites. This escalation of oppression significantly intensifies the suffering of the Israelite community. The decree to cast newborn boys into the Nile not only threatens their future generations, but also imposes a severe psychological and emotional toll on the entire community. The pain of such a decree is unimaginable, casting a shadow of grief and fear over the Israelite families. Conclusion, a testimony to courage and faith. The story of the midwife's defiance and Pharaoh's subsequent decree plays a crucial role in the Exodus narrative. It sets a backdrop of profound suffering and moral crisis against which the story of deliverance will unfold. The midwife's courageous stand serves as a testament to the power of faith and moral conviction in the face of tyranny. Their defiance is a beacon of hope and resistance, foreshadowing the eventual triumph of God's justice over human cruelty. The birth of Moses. Moses' birth amid persecution. In the midst of the Israelites' suffering and Pharaoh's cruel decree, a child named Moses, Moshe in Hebrew, meaning to draw out, is born to a Levite couple, Amram and Yochebed. His birth occurs at a time when every newborn Hebrew boy faces the threat of death, making his arrival both a time of joy and a moment of fear for his family. Yochebed's protective actions. Understanding the grave danger posed by Pharaoh's edict, Yochebed takes extraordinary measures to protect her son. For 3 months, she manages to hide him, keeping his presence a secret to save him from being killed. However, as Moses grows and it becomes increasingly difficult to conceal his presence, Yochebed devises a daring plan to save her son's life. The basket in the Nile. In an act of both desperation and faith, Yochebed places Moses in a basket made of papyrus and coats it with bitumen and pitch to make it waterproof. She then sets the basket adrift in the Nile River, entrusting her child's fate to a higher power. This action is emblematic of a mother's love and her hope for her child's survival against all odds. Discovery by Pharaoh's daughter. The basket carrying Moses is found by Pharaoh's daughter while she is bathing in the river. Moved by compassion upon hearing the baby's cries, she decides to adopt him. Unaware of his Hebrew identity and the decree of her father, she raises Moses in the Egyptian royal palace. In a twist of fate, the child destined to challenge Pharaoh's authority and liberate the Israelites is nurtured and educated in the heart of Egyptian power. The irony of Moses' upbringing. Moses' upbringing in Pharaoh's palace is laden with irony. The very person who will later lead the charge against Egyptian tyranny and oppression is raised as an Egyptian prince. This unique upbringing equips Moses with insights into Egyptian culture and governance, which will later play a crucial role in his leadership of the Israelites. Conclusion, the providential preservation of Moses. The story of Moses' birth and survival is a powerful testament to the themes of providence and hope in the Exodus narrative. His preservation and upbringing under the nose of Pharaoh highlights the mysterious ways in which divine plans unfold. Moses' early life sets the stage for his eventual role as the leader of the Israelite Exodus, showcasing the interplay of human action and divine guidance in the unfolding of biblical history. Moses' plight to Midian. Moses' act of defiance. As an adult raised in the Egyptian royal palace, Moses becomes acutely aware of his Hebrew heritage and the plight of his people. This awareness leads to a pivotal moment when he witnessed an Egyptian taskmaster mistreating a Hebrew slave. In a spontaneous act of defense and outrage, Moses intervenes and kills the Egyptian. This act, born out of sense of justice and kinship with the Hebrews, marks a turning point in his life. The consequences of his actions. Moses' intervention, meant to protect his fellow Hebrew, quickly backfires. Word of his deed reaches Pharaoh, who perceives Moses' action as a threat and orders his execution. Moses, now a fugitive in the land where he grew up as a prince, is forced to flee for his life, abandoning the comforts and security of his adopted royal home. The journey to Midian. Moses' plight leads him to Midian, a region far from the reach of Egyptian authority. In Midian, he seeks refuge from the wrath of Pharaoh and an uncertain future. This journey is not just a physical escape, but also represents a transition of Moses' identity from an Egyptian prince to a Hebrew exile, seeking a new path in life. Encounter at the well. In Midian, Moses encounters the daughters of Reuel, also known as Jethro, a Midianite priest. At a well where the daughters come to draw water, they are harassed by shepherds. Moses, continuing his instinct to defend the oppressed, intervenes once again and helps them. This act of kindness and bravery endears him to the family of Reuel. Marriage to Sephora. Moses' stay in Midian leads to a significant personal development. He marries Sephora, one of Reuel's daughters, integrating into the Midianite community. This marriage signifies Moses' transition into a new phase of life, one that distances him from his past in Egypt and prepares him for his future role as the leader of the Israelites. Moses in Midian, a period of preparation. Moses' time in Midian is a period of transformation and preparation. Away from the luxuries of Egypt, he adopts a simpler life, working as a shepherd in the service of his father-in-law. This period is essential for Moses, not only in terms of personal growth, but also in preparing him spiritually and emotionally for the monumental task that lies ahead, leading the Israelites out of Egypt. Conclusion: a new beginning in Midian. Moses' plight to Midian marks the end of his early life as an Egyptian and the beginning of his true mission as the leader and liberator of his people. In Midian, Moses finds a new family, a new way of life, and ultimately, a new sense of purpose. This phase of his life is crucial in shaping the man who would become the great prophet and leader of the Exodus. The burning bush. The encounter at Horeb. In the midst of his ordinary life as a shepherd, Moses experiences an extraordinary event that changes the course of his life and the history of the Israelites. While tending the flock of his father-in-law Reuel or Jethro in the region of Horeb, he witnesses a remarkable sight, a bush that is burning but not consumed by the flames. Theophany, God's revelation in the burning bush. This phenomenon, known as theophany, a visible manifestation of God to humans, marks a pivotal moment in the biblical narrative. The burning bush is a symbol of God's presence and power, an extraordinary sign that captures Moses' attention and compels him to investigate. As Moses approaches, God calls out to him from the bush, initiating a divine encounter. God's commission to Moses. From the burning bush, God commissions Moses to return to Egypt and lead the Israelites out of slavery. This calling marks a significant shift in Moses' life, from a shepherd in Midian to a leader and liberator of his people. God's command signifies the beginning of the fulfillment of the covenant promised made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Revelation of the Divine Name. In this encounter, God reveals His name to Moses as the Tetragrammaton, YHWH, or Yahweh, often translated as I am who I am, or I will be what I will be. This name signifies God's eternal existence, self-sufficiency, and unchanging nature. The revelation of this name is of profound significance, as it provides Moses and the Israelites a deeper understanding of God's character and His relationship with His people. The significance of the covenant. The revelation at the burning bush is not just a call to action. It is also a reaffirmation of God's ongoing covenant with the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God's words to Moses underscore His awareness of the Israelites' suffering in Egypt and His commitment to deliver them. It is a powerful reminder of God's faithfulness and His active role in the history of His chosen people. Moses' reluctance and God's assurance. Moses initially expresses reluctance to accept this daunting mission, citing his perceived inadequacies. However, God reassures Moses of His continual presence and support. God equips Moses with miraculous signs and promises him that the Israelites will listen to His voice, ensuring that Moses does not undertake this mission alone. Conclusion. The turning point for Israelites' liberation. The encounter with the burning bush is a turning point in Moses' life and a crucial moment in the narrative of Israel's liberation. It represents the initiation of God's plan to rescue His people from slavery and lead them to the promised land. This event sets in motion the series of events that will culminate in the Exodus, highlighting the themes of divine calling, revelation, and deliverance. The request to Pharaoh. Permit the Israelites to journey 3 days into the wilderness to worship God. This request is part of God's plan to liberate the Israelites from Egyptian bondage. The significance of the request. The request for a 3-day journey is significant for several reasons. It represents the Israelites' desire to freely worship and honor God, something they cannot do under the oppressive regime of Pharaoh. Furthermore, this request tests Pharaoh's willingness to acknowledge God's authority and the Israelites' religious rights. It serves as a diplomatic approach, requesting a temporary leave rather than immediate and total liberation, which might have been more confrontational. Pharaoh's skeptical reaction. Pharaoh, upon hearing this request, is skeptical and dismissive. He interprets the request as a ploy by the Israelites to shirk their duties and escape their labor. This reaction is indicative of Pharaoh's perception of the Israelites as mere slaves and his refusal to acknowledge their spiritual needs and rights. The hardening of Pharaoh's heart. Pharaoh's rejection of the request leads to a hardening of his heart. This hardening is a critical element in the Exodus narrative, as it sets the stage for the subsequent plagues that God will bring upon Egypt. Pharaoh's stubbornness and refusal to heed Moses' request demonstrate his defiance against God's will. The prelude to the plagues. Pharaoh's denial of the request is not merely a refusal to grant a leave of absence. It is a rejection of God's authority. This refusal escalates the conflict between God and Pharaoh, leading to the 10 plagues. The plagues serve as divine intervention to demonstrate God's power over Egypt and to compel Pharaoh to release the Israelites. The path to Exodus. The request to Pharaoh and his subsequent refusal are instrumental in setting in motion the events of the Exodus. They highlight the struggle between divine authority and earthly power, and the lengths of which God will go to free his people. This episode lays the groundwork for the dramatic demonstration of God's power and the eventual liberation of the Israelites. Conclusion, a catalyst for deliverance. Of Pharaoh, though simple in its nature, is a catalyst for the unfolding of the Exodus story. It represents the initial step in the divine plan for Israel's liberation and set the stage for the dramatic and powerful acts of God that will follow. This narrative underscores the themes of faith, defiance, and the pursuit of freedom against the backdrop of divine intervention and sovereignty. The Battle for Israel in Exodus. Introduction to Let My Son Go That He May Serve Me. Exodus 5-6. The Dilemma of Serving Pharaoh versus Serving God. The Israelites in Egypt face a crucial choice between serving Pharaoh and in bondage or serving God. After Moses' plea to Pharaoh to let the Israelites worship in the desert, Pharaoh intensifies their oppression. He denies them straw for brick making, yet demands the same quota, exacerbating their hardship and leading to complaints against Moses. In response, God reaffirms his promise to liberate the Israelites. Pharaoh's hardened heart. The theme of stubborn resistance. In the Exodus narrative, one of the central themes in Pharaoh's persistent refusal to let the Israelites go, despite the pleas of Moses and Aaron. This refusal is repeatedly described as a hardening of Pharaoh's heart. This hardened heart symbolizes his stubborn resistance to God's will and serves as a major obstacle in the path to Israelites' freedom. The nature of Pharaoh's hardness. Pharaoh's hardened heart is a complex interplay of his own arrogance, pride, and the cultural context in which he reigns. As the ruler of Egypt, a superpower of the ancient world, Pharaoh is accustomed to absolute power and control. His refusal to yield to Moses' demands is partly a result of his perception of himself as a divine figure above the commands of any god, particularly the god of a subjugated people. Hardening as self-induced. While the narrative mentions that God hardens Pharaoh's heart, it also suggests that Pharaoh himself plays a significant role in this hardening. This self-induced hardening can be interpreted as Pharaoh's deliberate choice to ignore the signs and wonders performed by God through Moses and Aaron. His repeated refusal reinforces his own obstinacy, leading to a cycle of increasing stubbornness. Arrogance and denial of God's authority. Pharaoh's resistance is not only against the Israelites' freedom, but also a denial of God's supreme authority. By refusing to acknowledge the power of the God of Israel, Pharaoh sets himself up in direct opposition to God. His hardened heart is therefore a manifestation of his arrogance and his challenge to divine power. The consequences of a hardened heart. Pharaoh's hardened heart leads to serious consequences for Egypt. Its refusal brings about a plague, causing immense suffering to the Egyptian people and the land. These plagues are designed to demonstrate God's power and authority, challenging Pharaoh's claims of divinity and his perception of invulnerability. The role of the hardened heart in the Exodus narrative. In the broader context of the Exodus story, the hardening of Pharaoh's heart serves as a dual purpose. It highlights the theme of liberation against seemingly insurmountable odds and showcases God's power to deliver his people. It also serves as a cautionary tale about the dangers of pride and resistance to divine will. Conclusion: a symbol of defiance against divine will. Pharaoh's hardened heart is a powerful symbol within the Exodus narrative, representing human defiance against divine will. It is a testament to the consequences of arrogance and the refusal to acknowledge a higher power. This theme resonates throughout the story, underlining the struggle between earthly authority and divine sovereignty. Pharaoh's claim of divinity. Pharaoh's divine status in Egyptian culture. In ancient Egyptian culture, the Pharaoh was not only a political ruler, but also considered a living god. This divine status was integral to Egyptian religion and governance. Pharaoh was seen as the intermediary between the gods and the people, maintaining Mahat or cosmic order through this rule. His claim of divinity was central to Egyptian societal structure and religious belief. Dismissal of the God of Israel. When confronted by Moses with the demand to let the Israelites go, Pharaoh's response, "I do not know the Lord," Exodus 5:2, is steeped in cultural and religious defiance. From his perspective as a divine ruler, acknowledging the God of Israel would be equivalent to admitting the existence of power of a deity greater than himself. His dismissal is thus an assertion of his perceived divine authority and a rejection of any power that challenges his own. The confrontation of divine and earthly powers. This scenario sets the stage for a profound confrontation, not just between two men, Moses and Pharaoh, but between divine authority as represented by God of Israel and the earthly power as embodied in Pharaoh. This confrontation is a key theme in the Exodus narrative, highlighting the struggle between the omnipotent God of the Hebrews and the human-made divinity of the Egyptian Pharaoh. Pharaoh's role in the Exodus narrative. Pharaoh's claim to divinity and his subsequent actions play a crucial role in the narrative Exodus. His resistance and the ensuing plagues become demonstration of God's supreme power over the gods of Egypt, including Pharaoh himself. Each challenge by Moses and its corresponding plague served to undermine Pharaoh's claim to divinity, showing the Egyptians and the Israelites alike that their ruler is no match for the God of Israel. Theological implications. Pharaoh's stance also has deep theological implications. It brings into question the nature of divine authority, and the limits of human power. The Exodus story, through the figure of Pharaoh, explores themes of pride, idolatry, and the folly of human claims to divinity in the face of the true and living God. Conclusion, a clash of divinities. Pharaoh's claim of divinity and his confrontation with Moses symbolizes the fundamental clash between the ideologies of divine kingship and monotheistic worship. This conflict is central to the narrative of Exodus, showcasing the ultimate triumph of God's will over human arrogance and the liberation that comes from divine intervention against oppressive earthly powers. The Ten Plagues, Exodus 7:12. Judgment against Egypt, false God. The Ten Plagues. The Ten Plagues as divine demonstrations. The Ten Plagues, as recounted in the book of Exodus, represent a series of powerful judgments against the pantheon of Egyptian gods. Each plague systematically targets the deities revered in Egyptian religion, demonstrating their impotence in the face of God of Israel. These plagues serve a dual purpose. They are both punitive towards Pharaoh and Egypt for the enslavement of the Israelites, and revelatory, revealing the supremacy and authority of the God of Israel. First plague, Nile to blood. Targeted deity, the Nile god, Hapi. Significance: the Nile, considered the lifeblood of Egypt and revered as a divine source, is turned to blood, demonstrating God's power over Egypt's source of life and prosperity. Second plague, frogs. Targeted deity, Heket, the frog-headed goddess of fertility. Significance: the inundation of frogs, turning a symbol of fertility into a source of plague, signifies the disruption of the natural order that Egyptians attributed to their gods. Third plague, gnats or lice. Targeted deity, Geb, the god of the earth. Significance: the dust of the earth becoming gnats or lice undermines the authority of Geb, challenging the Egyptians' trust in their gods' protection and provision. Fourth plague, swarms of flies. Targeted deity, Khepre, the god of creation, movement of the sun, and rebirth. Significance: the plague of flies, causing chaos and discomfort, defies the order and harmony associated with Khepre. Fifth plague, livestock disease. Targeted deity, Hathor, a goddess often depicted as a cow. Significance: the death of livestock is a direct blow to Hathor, undermining her role as a protector and nurturer. Sixth plague, boils. Targeted deity, Isis, a goddess of medicine and peace. Significance: the plague of boils, affecting both human and animals, demonstrates the inability of Isis to heal and protect from diseases. Seventh plague, hail. Targeted deity, Nut, the sky goddess. Significance: the storm of hail and fire from the sky challenges the authority of Nut, showing God's dominion over heavens. Eighth plague, locust. Targeted deity, Set, the god of storms and disorder. Significance: the locust bringing devastation and chaos directly confronts Set's domain, illustrating his impotence to control or prevent the disaster. Ninth plague, darkness. Targeted deity, Ra, the sun god. Significance: the overwhelming darkness even in the daytime. is a direct challenge to Ra, the most important deity in the Egyptian pantheon, showcasing his inability to bring light. 10th plague, death of the firstborn, targeted deity. Pharaoh himself, considered a god and protector of the realm. Significance: the death of the firstborn, impacting every Egyptian household, including Pharaoh, represents the ultimate judgment against Pharaoh's claimed divinity, demonstrating his powerlessness to protect his own people. Conclusion: a divine confrontation. The 10 plagues are more than just punitive measures. They represent a profound confrontation between the God of Israel and the entire pantheon of Egyptian gods. Through these acts, God demonstrates his power, authority, and supremacy, not only to affirm his covenant with Israel, but also to challenge Egyptians' belief in their deities. This series of divine interventions highlights the central theme of the Exodus story: the triumph of the one true God over human-made gods and the liberation of his people from bondage. The Passover and its significance. Institution of the Passover. The Passover is one of the most significant events in Jewish history and religious traditions. It is instituted on the eve of the Israelites' exodus from Egypt as a perpetual commemoration of their deliverance by God. The Passover marks the final decisive plague, the death of the firstborn in Egypt, and the sparing of the Israelites from this fate. The blood of the lamb as a symbol of salvation. Central to the observance of Passover is the sacrifice of a lamb without blemish and the application of its blood to the doorposts and lintels of Israelite homes. This act serves as a sign to the angel of death to pass over these homes during the plague. The blood of the lamb symbolizes salvation, protection, and God's covenant with his people. For Christians, this symbol is later echoed in the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, referred to as the Lamb of God, representing his death as atonement for sin. The power of faith and obedience. The Passover is also a profound demonstration of faith and obedience. The Israelites, following God's instruction through Moses, display their faith in God's promise and deliverance. Their obedience to the ritual of Passover becomes a key factor in their salvation from the plague and their subsequent liberation. Liberation from bondage. The Passover leads directly to the liberation of the Israelites from Egyptian slavery. This event is not only a physical emancipation, but also represents a spiritual deliverance. The act of God passing over the Israelites signifies his mercy and the establishment of Israel as his chosen people. The Passover as a perpetual observance. God commands the Israelites to observe the Passover annually as a lasting ordinance. This observance is a reminder to their bondage in Egypt, the pain of slavery, the joy of deliverance, and the power of God's intervention in human history. It is a time for the Jewish community to remember their collective story and identity as a people formed and saved by God. Christian interpretation and significance. In Christianity, the Passover finds additional meaning in the context of Jesus' Last Supper, which was a Passover meal. This event is seen as prefiguring Jesus' own sacrifice, his death and resurrection, which Christians believe offers spiritual liberation from sin. Thus, the Passover is viewed as a symbol of salvation and a foreshadowing of the new covenant in Christ. conclusion, a celebration of deliverance and divine faithfulness. The Passover is a multifaceted celebration, rich in symbolism and profound in its implications. It commemorates historical deliverance and serves as a testament to divine faithfulness and power. For both Jews and Christians, the Passover remains a poignant reminder of God's ability to liberate, save, and transform lives. Consecration of the Hebrew first word, Exodus 13. Dedication to God, consecration of the firstborn. Commandment of consecration. Following the miraculous deliverance from Egypt, God commands the Israelites to consecrate every firstborn male, both human and animal, to Him. This commandment is a direct response to the 10th plague, the death of the firstborn in Egypt, which was the decisive act leading to Pharaoh's capitulation and the subsequent liberation of the Israelites. Significance of the firstborn in ancient cultures. In ancient cultures, the firstborn held a special status. They were often seen as the primary heir and successor in a family, carrying significant familial and social responsibilities. In the context of the Exodus, the firstborn represented the strength and future of each family. Symbolism of consecration. The consecration of the firstborn is rich in symbolism. It is an acknowledgement of God's sovereignty and a recognition of His direct intervention in sparing the firstborn of Israel during the final plague. By dedicating the firstborn to God, the Israelites acknowledge that their survival and freedom are gifts from God, and in return, they dedicate their most precious to Him, a continual reminder of God's deliverance. This act of consecration serves up as a perpetual reminder of the Israelites' deliverance from bondage in Egypt. It is meant to be a lasting ordinance, reminding future generations of God's mercy, power, and the cost of their freedom. This ritual embeds the memory of the Exodus into the very fabric of Israelite society and religion. Contrast with the Egyptian tragedy. The consecration takes on additional significance against the backdrop of the Egyptian tragedy, where the firstborn of Egypt were struck down. It highlights that stark contrast between the faith of the Egyptians and the mercy shown to the Israelites. In this way, the ritual is also a memorial of the judgment that led to their salvation. The firstborn as a metaphor for Israel. Biblically, the nation of Israel is often referred to as God's firstborn son, Exodus chapter 4, verse 22. The consecration of the firstborn thus symbolizes the entire nation's dedication to God. It represents Israel calling to be a holy and consecrated people, set apart for God's purposes. Conclusion. A covenant and redemptive act. The dedication of the firstborn is a covenantal act, symbolizing the Israelites' ongoing relationship with God, rooted in the historical reality of their deliverance. It is a powerful expression of gratitude and recognition of divine grace, serving as a continual reminder of the redemptive act that defines the identity of faith of the Israelite people. Crossing the Red Sea and God's provision in the desert. crossing the Red Sea, Exodus chapter 14 to 15. The redemptive event in Israel's history, crossing the Red Sea. Foundational event in Israel's nationhood. The crossing of the Red Sea stands as one of the most pivotal moments in Jewish history, symbolizing the birth of Israel as a nation. This extraordinary event, where the Israelites passed through the sea on dry ground with walls of water on either side, marks their transition from Egyptian slavery to freedom. It signifies not just a physical crossing, but a transformation from a group of slaves into a unified nation under God's guidance. Symbol of God's active liberation. The parting of the Red Sea is a profound demonstration of God's active intervention and power in human history. This miraculous event signifies God's direct involvement in liberating the Israelites, showcasing His commitment to fulfilling the promises made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's a testament of God's ability to deliver His people from seemingly impossible situations. Centrality to Israelite identity. The crossing of the Red Sea is central to the Israelite identity and consciousness. It's a story passed down through generations, serving as a constant reminder of their origin as a people chosen and saved by God. This event is celebrated annually during the Passover, ensuring that the memory of God's deliverance is never forgotten. Reflection of God's covenantal faithfulness. This event is also a powerful reflection of God's faithfulness to His covenant. The liberation from Egypt and the crossing of the Red Sea fulfill the divine promise of deliverance and set the stage for the establishment of a covenant at Sinai. It underscores the idea that the Israelites are a people defined by their relationship with God. Transition from slavery to nationhood. The crossing signifies a clear break from the past. The Israelites leave behind centuries of slavery and oppression and stepped into a new existence as a free nation. This transition is both a physical and spiritual journey as the Israelites learn to rely on God and understand their identity as His chosen people, a model of redemption and hope. For generations of Jews and later Christians, the crossing of the Red Sea serves as a model of redemption and hope. It is a powerful symbol of God's ability to save and transform, offering hope, and no matter the circumstances, liberation and salvation are possible with divine intervention. Conclusion, a defining moment in biblical narrative. The crossing of the Red Sea is a defining moment in the biblical narrative and in the history of the Israelite people. It's an event that encapsulates themes of deliverance, faith, divine power, and the birth of a nation. This story continues to inspire and affirm faith in God's saving power and His ongoing relationship with His people. The Paschal Lamb and Christian Significance. Prefiguration of Jesus as the Paschal Lamb. In Christian theology, the Passover Lamb in the Exodus narrative is seen as a prefiguration of Jesus Christ, often referred to as the Paschal Lamb. The sacrificial lamb during Passover, whose blood saved the Israelites from the angel of death, is seen as a symbol of Jesus, whose death and resurrection would bring salvation to humanity. Exodus as a symbol of salvation. The story of the Exodus, particularly the Passover event, holds profound significance for Christians. It is interpreted as an antecedent to the ultimate salvation brought about by Christ's passion, death, and resurrection. just as the blood of the lamb on the doorpost saved the Israelites, Christ's blood shed on the cross is seen as offering salvation and eternal life to all who believe. Extension of liberation to all humanity. In the Christian context, the liberation experienced by the Israelites is extended to a spiritual liberation for all humanity. Through Christ's sacrificial death, Christians believe that the dominion of sin and death has been defeated. This salvation is not limited to a particular ethnic group, but is offered to all people, symbolizing the inclusive nature of God's saving grace. The Last Supper and the Eucharist. The Last Supper, which Jesus shared with his disciples, is understood in Christianity as a Passover meal. During this meal, Jesus instituted the Eucharist, symbolizing his body and blood, as the new covenant between God and humanity. This event draws direct parallel to the Passover meal and the sacrificial lamb, underscoring Jesus' role as the Paschal Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Fulfillment of Old Testament prophecies. The Paschal Lamb in Christian theology is also seen as the fulfillment of Old Testament prophecies and rituals. The sacrificial system in the Old Testament, particularly the Passover lamb, is viewed as foreshadowing the ultimate sacrifice of Jesus for the sins of the world. A new understanding of liberation. The Paschal Lamb brings a new understanding of liberation in Christian theology. While the Exodus was a physical and national liberation for the Israelites, the sacrifice of Jesus is seen as offering a spiritual and universal liberation from sin and death, a liberation that brings reconciliation between God and humanity. Conclusion. A central theme in Christian faith. The Paschal Lamb is a central theme in Christian faith, encapsulating the core message of redemption and salvation. The link between the Passover lamb in the Exodus and the sacrifice of Jesus Christ forms a fundamental pillar in Christian doctrine, illustrating the continuity between the Old and New Testaments and God's plan for human salvation. God's provision in the desert, Exodus 16-17, manna from heaven. Divine provision in the wilderness. In the narrative of the Israelites' journey through the wilderness, one of the most significant events is the provision of manna from heaven. After their exodus from Egypt, the Israelites faced the harsh realities of life in the desert, including the dire need for food. In response to their plight and murmuring, God miraculously provides manna, a substance described as bread from heaven, which appears each morning. The significance of manna. Manna represents more than just physical sustenance. It is a symbol of God's care and provision for His people in their time of need. The daily appearance of manna teaches the Israelites to depend on God for their daily needs. This reliance on divine provision is a lesson in faith and trust, as the Israelites are instructed to gather only as much manna as they can for each day, except on the sixth day, when they collect a double portion in preparation for the Sabbath. Manna as a test and humbling experience. The provision of manna also serves as a test and a means to humble the Israelites. In Deuteronomy 8:16, it is noted that God fed them with manna to humble them and to test their obedience to His commands. This experience teaches them to follow God's instructions and to recognize their dependence on Him, not only for physical sustenance, but also for spiritual guidance. Christian interpretation. Jesus as the bread of life. In Christian theology, manna is seen as a precursor of Jesus Christ, who in the New Testament is referred to as the bread of life. This connection is drawn particularly from the discourse in the Gospel of John, John chapter 6, verse 31 to 35, where Jesus compares himself to the manna that was provided to the Israelites. He teaches that while manna sustains physical life, he offers spiritual sustenance and eternal life. Manna as a symbol of God's sustaining word. In both Jewish and Christian traditions, manna symbolizes not just physical nourishment, but also spiritual nourishment that comes from God's word. Just as the Israelites were sustained daily by manna, believers are taught to seek sustenance and guidance daily from their faith and God's teachings. Conclusion: a lesson in divine providence and faith. The story of manna from heaven is a powerful lesson in divine providence and the importance of faith. It highlights the need for continual reliance on God and understanding that true sustenance, both physical and spiritual, comes from Him. For Christians, the manna is also a typological symbol of Christ, reinforcing the theme of God's ongoing provision for humanity. Victory over enemies, the battle against Amalekites. The battle in Exodus 17. In Exodus 17, the Israelites encounter one of their first major battles after leaving Egypt, the battle against the Amalekites. This event is significant not only as a physical confrontation, but also a spiritual and faith-building experience for the nascent nation of Israel. Moses' role and the raising of the staff. The battle is remarkable for the way victory is achieved. Moses, the leader of the Israelites, plays a key role not through direct combat, but through an act of faith. As he raises his staff, the same staff used to part the Red Sea, Israel gains the upper hand in the battle. This act symbolizes God's power and presence working through the faith and obedience of Moses, and by extension, the Israelite people. Symbolism of the raised staff. The raised staff of Moses is a powerful symbol in the Exodus narrative. It represents God's authority and the miraculous power He exercises on behalf of His people. In the context of the battle, the staff's elevation signifies divine intervention and assurance of victory, as long as the Israelites maintain their faith and reliance on God. Aaron and Hur's support. A notable aspect of this battle is the support Moses receives from Aaron and Hur. As the battle progresses and Moses grows weary, Aaron and Hur provide physical support by holding up his arms. This act is a poignant illustration of the importance of community and mutual support, especially in times of hardship and trial. It underscores the idea that victory in battle, both physical and spiritual, often requires collective effort and unity, faith and God's intervention. The battle against Amalekites highlights the theme of faith and reliance on God in overcoming challenges. It demonstrates that while human effort is necessary, ultimate victory comes from God. This event serves as a reminder to the Israelites that their success and survival as a nation depend on their faithfulness and trust in God's power and guidance. A lesson in spiritual warfare. The battle also serves as a lesson in spiritual warfare. It illustrates that the struggles and battles faced by the people of God are not just physical but also spiritual in nature. The victory over the Amalekites symbolizes the triumph of faith and divine power over adversity and opposition. Conclusion: a testament to divine power and faith. The victory over the Amalekites in Exodus 17 is a testament to the power of faith and the reality of divine intervention in the struggles of God's people. It reinforces the importance of community support and unity in facing challenges and serves as a powerful reminder of the central role of faith and reliance on God in achieving victory over enemies. Conclusion: from slavery to freedom. The journey to true freedom beyond physical liberation. The story of the Exodus, the journey of the Israelites from slavery in Egypt to freedom, is a narrative rich in both historical and spiritual significance. It represents more than the physical liberation from bondage. It encapsulates a journey toward the spiritual awakening and growth. This journey to true freedom is a multifaceted process involving both external liberation and internal transformation. Recognition of the need for liberation. A critical aspect of the Israelites' journey is the recognition of their need for liberation. While the physical suffering in Egypt is apparent, the acknowledgement of their need for deliverance from spiritual and psychological bondage is equally important. It involves a deep understanding of their identity as a people chosen by God and the realization that true freedom comes from living in alignment with His will. Embracing liberation. The Israelites' exodus is not just about escaping physical chains, but also about choosing to embrace the freedom offered by God. This choice involves trust and faith in God's promises and a willingness to step into the unknown, leaving behind the familiarity of bondage for the promise of a better future. This act of embracing liberation is a key step in the journey to true freedom. Spiritual awakening and development. Throughout their journey, the Israelites experience a spiritual awakening and development. This process is marked by moments of doubt, fear, and rebellion, but also by moments of faith, growth, and deeper understanding of God. The journey through the wilderness serves as a time of purification and preparation for entering the Promised Land, symbolizing the spiritual growth necessary for true freedom, a metaphor for personal and collective liberation. The journey of the Israelites serves as a powerful metaphor for anyone seeking freedom from various forms of bondage, be it physical, emotional, or spiritual. It illustrates that true freedom is a holistic concept, encompassing not just the absence of physical constraints, but also the presence of spiritual peace, purpose, and fulfillment. The role of community in the journey. The Exodus story also highlights the importance of community in the journey to freedom. The Israelites' liberation is not just an individual experience, but a collective one. It underscores the idea that freedom is often achieved and experienced in community through mutual support, shared struggles, and common goals. Conclusion: a continuous journey. The journey to true freedom as exemplified by the Israelites, is a continuous process. It doesn't end with the crossing of the Red Sea or even with the entry into the Promised Land. It is an ongoing journey of learning to live in freedom, continually choosing faith over fear, and embracing the fullness of life that God offers.
Thank you for joining us in the episode of our series on Egypt and Exodus. Today we explore the dramatic transition of the Israelites from being honored guests under Joseph's protection to oppressed slaves under the new Pharaoh, who did not remember Joseph's contribution. We looked at how a severe famine led Jacob's family to Egypt, initially under God's providential care, and how their circumstances shifted drastically over time. We also delve into the oppressive measures imposed by the new Pharaoh, the courageous defiance of the midwife, and the birth and early life of Moses, who would later become a pivotal figure in the deliverance of Israel. This period of intense suffering set the stage for divine interventions and the eventual exodus from Egypt. In our next episode, we will focus on Israel's identity formation. We will explore how the Israelites transitioned from slaves to chosen nation under God's covenant, becoming a kingdom of priests and holy nation. We'll delve into the central role of worship and service in their identity, and how the law and the covenant given at Mount Sinai shaped their national and religious life. Be sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified of our next episode, where we'll provide a comprehensive understanding of Israel's journey from slavery to becoming a holy nation and the significance of the law, tabernacle, and the Shabbat in their worship and daily life. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next episode.